The chieftaincy election of the Kalayewo Kenu House, Okuru Ama Port Harcourt River State. On Saturday, 3rd October 2020, the entire Kalayewo House members gathered at the family compound for the voting and selection process of the chief and head of Kalayewo Kenu House in Okuru Ama Port Harcourt. The various contestants are Mr. Iderefa Mama N. Gabriel, Mr. Charles Kalayewo, and Mr. Tamino Opubo Thompson. The process begins with an opening prayer by Reverend Iwariso Ivy, where he prayed and commits the election process unto God Almighty.
On this blood in my hands, I decree, Lord, you will honor your name.
Yes, amen.
And you bring glory on this house.
Amen.
Lord, this oil in my heart stands as your blood. As I drop it on this floor, your presence shall rest in this family.
Amen.
And even upon the life of the man to emerge as the chief of this house, your blood shall always speak against every other demonic lords. Oh God, your blood shall speak against every demonic altar.
Yes.
Today, I decree by the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
No other altar shall speak for you against his house.
Yes,
but your blood. No other incantation, libation, vocation against the chief of elected shall work. Except the blood of the Lamb. Dear Lord, I drop this blood in your name. That through you coming, there shall be peace.
Amen.
Through you coming, there shall be unity.
Amen.
There will be love.
Amen.
There will be growth.
Amen.
There will be prosperity.
Amen.
I decree in the name of God the Father.
Amen.
In the name of the Son.
Amen.
And of the Holy
Spirit.
The chairman of Kalayewo Kenu House, Mr. James Kalayewo, gave a brief remark based on the code of conduct. The election was masterminded by the Electoral Committee with the Okuru Ama CDC representative headed by Mr. Coxon Ibianga, the PRO of Okuru Ama CDC. During the election proper, all eligible candidates voted and the collations of results was done by the returning officer.
Five. 43,
44.
Thank you, baby.
2,
3,
4,
5,
53, 54, 55, 56. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Mr. Clement George, the Eleko chairman, who officially declared Dickin Charles Aikalayo as the winner with 56 votes. On Wednesday, 14 October 2020, the family proceeded with the chief elect, Chief Dickin Charles Aikalayo, to Ewemigwe of Tumoniju Kirike in Okrika Kingdom for the Imunumunupo ceremony. The ceremony was conducted by Chief Sunday Oba, the Vice Chairman of Tumoniju Kirike Council of Chiefs, with the presence of other chiefs, elders, and youth of Ewemi, kingmakers of Okrika Kingdom. The chief elect proceeded to his hometown, Okuru Ama. And was received by the various chairmen and houses of Kalayo Walking House. Thanksgiving and protection was offered to God Almighty by Mr. Precious Stamps on Enemy, and the servant of God bless him with anointing oil. Some family members expressed their view based on this selection and Imunumunukpo ceremony.
I would say, if assuming INEC was here to come and witness what we have done, it was done in a transparent way. Everybody could witness or attest to the fact that it was free, fair, credible election. And that is what we intend to do, and that is what we have achieved. So to the glory of God, we have elected a God-fearing man who we have already looked up to, and God today has given us a leader. So I'm delighted.
It's very unfair. We're still waiting for the time to count for some people and numbers.
Looking at what has been happening, it's free and fair. People are really, people are well behaved, no issues. For now, we are waiting for the coalitions to start by 1 p.m.
We are here for AJ to make sure the election is free and fair, which we've just done, and waiting for the coalition.
The election, well, I take it a good faith. There's no problem. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'm one of the aspirants of this Chitansi election. My name is Derfama Nicholas Gabriel. I'm so delighted that my brother Charles Alayu is the winner of the election. I accepted the election.
Ceremony of Kaleyu is Imunumunukpo
the make the imunumunu in our tradition is second of the ways to become chief. Chief means to lead the house affair, to become a chief. So this is the number one starting point of imunumunu. The Kaliyo house, I have chosen someone, Charles Kaliyo, the first to the house, to the people, that this is our chief to become. This is the starting point. That is the meaning of Imunumunu. We have selected our man to become our leader. Thank God we are here in the first election, that everything goes well. If every person do the way we do our election, I don't think that will be crisis. The weakness how we do the election is free and fair. Everyone, even every participant, confirm that he is the winner. And today too, convene everybody down to our mother's home, which is Okrika, to do this thing. Everything was peaceful. It was goes everywhere. You can see that there was no quarrel or fight. To tell you that we choose the right candidate to lead us. If you don't choose the right candidate, you will see difficulties, you will see quarrel and all that. So for you to witness the chiefs, everybody come out in mass, the youth and the elders, they came and they did everything. To tell you that there is nothing hidden under the sun, you understand? So if you bring out the right choice, you will not have any challenge. There are a lot of challenge, tens of like this in our clan, Okrika. You understand? Like this now, we cannot see them. Like this now, the chiefs will be running. I've witnessed so many of that. But in our case, you see that we bring out the right one. So we did not have any fear. Everybody was sitting comfortably. Everybody, we did our thing, everything amicable. There is no quarrel or anything, because we bring out the right candidate for the people.
What we are observing today is the first step of the shift and the stool. We call it installation ceremony. Probably known as a Imunumunu power ceremony. We have gone to our headquarters in Okrika and we have done it. We have now returned back to our ancestral home, Okuruma, in Kaliyo Walking House. And right from the beginning, Kaliyo family is known as a family that is well coordinated. People are dedicated, people are God fearing. So whoever emerges at the end of the day automatically becomes our choice, becomes our vote, and is going to be our leader. And exactly what we have done. So everybody is impressed with what is happening. The entire community is impressed with what happening. Why you are not seeing so much crowd as expected is that it's more or less a low key. By the time we go for the full coronation ceremony, you see a number of persons from outside and inside coming to celebrate with us. And what I expect the new chief to do is to ensure that definitely he came through an elections, impress everybody in a democratic process, impress everybody, whether your opponent, whether your supporter, it doesn't matter. Everybody embrace him as one indivisible family and carry everybody along, particularly in the fear of God. Because if a leader does not have the fear of God, you are leading people, you will lead people astray. But when you have the fear of God, God will definitely lead you to lead your people well. And when God leads you, you will definitely lead the people well. That's my prayer for you.
The Imunumunu ceremony that we have just done today is about officially presenting a candidate to the entire community, who is chief elect, to pilot them there. So for now, the Imunumunu process is officially making you the chief elect. Then before the don't worry, is making you an official chief in the whole of Africa. But this one, we have two sections of Africa, which is the Tuburunju side of Africa. Then when the don is being done, the don wearing is being taken place, you become Se Alamo, Police Alamo. So for now, we are happy that we have a man who is God fearing, is also taking a church, which we pray for. But we thank God that all those things come out. So that is what the Imunumunu call is all about. It's just, you know, they always say power comes from God. It was not easy when we took over. We took over our power from March this year, and we are in October. So barely 5 months, which has never been done in history of this community, that an executive came into power, making sure that the family become a working house, and also conducted a free and fair election, where one or two persons emerged to contest. You cannot just pick someone, like, you know, the one person, but this is our own reason. So we have to fought for a week, for which is election, which we did, and it was accepted, was free and fairer than even the US election. So for that, as a scribe of the house, I give kudos to myself. Let me be like the lizard for once, nodding my head that yes, I've done what I expected him to bring the family together, to pilot the affair. Yes, after election, there might be those who are bereaved, who feel they are coasted to victory, and all of a sudden, the hand of God turned to make him the. So you should know that it's God that chooses, not human. We will be only there as humans, as the channel to which a candidate will emerge. But my only advice to him, my chief, which I want to closely work with, that he should always seek the face of God, because it's only God that can direct and put it through in all the affairs, especially this side of our community is so difficult. Even when we have not used one error, they would abuse you of misusing, misappropriate, all those kind of things. So we have really gone through my chairman and myself, but I just want to thank God that we have someone who has emerged in the scene, who is going to pilot over our affairs, and I believe we took the right decision of bringing someone of this caliber. So I once again congratulate him for a job well done, for also availing himself, because there's another thing for you to contest, there's another thing to avail. When you look at this thing, the candidates, the kind of people that want to contest with you, you know that, can I be able to stand the firepower of this? So him availing himself to be used as a tool, I give him thanks.
Today, you know, before this time, we are struggling as a family, according to the tradition of Okirika land, Okirika nationality. We struggle to happen as a family, to happen to be we call it Omwaro, that's a walk in new house. Yes, that signify as a man that you are autonomous on your own. Yes, we will break out from the great Opuchukwu, walk in new house, the ancient walk in new house. So when a family get to the stage in population, to a standard, a number of people, the whole kingdom of Okirika nationality will commend you that yes, you're up to the standard to become a walk in new house. So on the process, we happen to follow the procedures according to one after the other. Yeah, we went to the process of chonkeying. That is a head count. It's not easy. It's not easy. But yes, I'm very grateful that my family happened to be the highest populated family in the whole of Okuruma, in Port Harcourt City local government. Yeah, after that process, they now give us the certificate of recognition. Here we are. Today, we happen to select, we happen to select the chief elect. On the process, he emerged, being the chairs, I Kalayo, the head chiefs of Kalayo Walking New House, emerged as the chief of Kalayo Walking New House. I'm very happy. Today, the Momonokpo, we call it Momonokpo. Yeah, it's a raffia, a pantry raffia. Yes, that is our symbol. It's not a fetish belief. According to the culture, you follow. He is a deacon. He's a pastor. You know, even the scripture, we heard it, that when the righteous rule, the people rejoice. He's a deacon. When you look at his name, you see a deacon. Yeah. We need people like that. Even in the states, even in the federation. Yeah, we need people like that. But I pray, let God give him the wisdom. That wisdom he gave to Solomon, to give to him, to rule his people. Yes. Because some people, we see them, when they get to this position, maybe worldly things, when they see money and all the rest, they forget where they come from. He should remember. That's my prayer for him now. He should remember where he come out from. Lead his people. He should not be betrayed. He should not be boycotted. He should go forward. That is my prayer. If you can see, as his arrival, normally, according to the tradition, we suppose like it. Pour hot drinks. But instead, we are up enough to now. We are still waiting for the clergy to come. The time he gave and the time we arrived did not come through. But they will come. When they come, they will still give their testimony. You understand? So I'm very happy to tell the whole public they should relate. It's good. It's good. Instead of going to use an alcoholic, a hot drink, to labate, we use water. It purifies. It cleans out. He gives joy. Nobody, there is nobody that did not deal with water. Nobody. A man cannot come and that did not deal with water. We cook with it. We drink it. Even a newborn baby needs water.
It's life.
Yes, it's alive. That is what the Lord said. Yes. So that's what we did. We are still waiting for the clergy. They are coming. It's awesome. People will emulate from it.
Sure.
Yeah, it's awesome. I wish people will emulate from it. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, even up to the extent Christ said in the book of Matthew, people that are coming at my back is greater than me. So people, when they see this ceremony, the Momonopo ceremony, they will know that, yes, they will emulate and do better than us. That's what we expect. Yes, this is the great Kalayo Work in New House. Yes, it's a very large house. We are very large, over 200 in population. It's not easy. Over 200 men. We are not talking about women. Men, over 200. Yes, and according to Krika tradition, it's 800. But we are clocked. So if you can see, we are up to 200 SF, according to some standard. So when you hear that, don't doubt. We are expecting that.
Good morning, the press man.
I'm very happy. I think you can see I'm happy. God bless you.
We saw how the Chisuno Krika came out in the very early hours of the day. And also how your family members came and they have problems. So, how do you feel seeing these people coming out to
the Yes, it is tradition. By Krika tradition, tying of the palm front is done early in the morning. Very early in the morning. And that shows fruitfulness, bravery. That shows that we the Krikans, we wake in the early in the morning to do our things. So the installation of chief also, they used to do it quiet in the morning before the sun is too high. That is why they came by that time. God bless you.
So what's the significance of this ceremony today?
Yes. You know, the school of a chief is a lifelong stool. And so you can see there the significance of this palm front according to our tradition. We believe that the life tree and the palm front, these two trees live very longer to show that as you are coming to rule the people, you are going to rule them for a very long time. Chief don't resign, chief don't leave the position. You will remain as a chief until God in heaven take you home. And that is why the significance of the palm front and the live tree leaves was used.
So sir, looking at the Kalayo Work in New House, what feedback will you give to them since they came to support you from the election and now they follow you to that place? Hope you will not disappoint them.
No, by God's grace, I will not disappoint them. You know, they are the ones that choose me. It is not a political something. It is our way of life that when the house become in this manner, they will choose a particular person that will rule them. And that is what they have exactly done. So I thank them. They did what is right. And my God will bless them. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Stay tuned to Pure Minds TV Port Harcourt as we bring to you the installation and admission of Chief Deacon Charles Kalayu into the Okrika Divisional Council of Chiefs. I'm on a promise X, Pure Minds TV Port Harcourt.